Well, Aaron, it's called the Pajaro Bench Excavation Project, which will be done in two phases. The first phase runs about 3 miles. Work began today and should be completed late October. The second phase will begin next summer and covers about 5 miles of the river. Combined, the two projects will remove about 300,000 cubic yards of sediment. Big rig trucks line up along the Pajaro River, receiving their fill of sediment along the Pajaro Flood Control Channel from Highway 1 up to Salas Fuentes Creek, an area that's about 3 miles long.
We call it the bench area, and what we're doing is removing the excess soil deposits that have built over time. So essentially it opens up the channel. We believe it will provide some minor capacity improvements.
Crews will remove 130,000 yards of cubic earth. That means there will be 13,000 big rig trucks carrying their loads off-site.
All this dirt will be taken to a couple of places, and we'll go ahead and use it as cover for our landfills, and we also will probably be using it for other purposes.
Work along the river has been hindered in the past because it is a habitat for steelhead and western pond turtles and other wildlife. But the county is working with the biologist.
Overall, I mean, there's a lot of species that use the corridor here, from bobcats to hawks and other large birds and nesting birds. And so pretty much we watch out for everything, and we do the compliance monitoring for all the state and federal permits.
The Pajaro River has breached its banks and caused flooding in 1955, 1958, 1995, and most recently in 1998. Back in 1995, Lakeside organic garden owner Dick Pachotti lost acres of crops to the flooding. He sees this excavation project as a beginning.
Anything is an improvement. So, you know, we've waited a long time to get this done. We've been pretty frustrated with all the government entities that have put in roadblocks to, you know, a process that needs to happen.
The cost of the project is about $8 million. It's being split with Monterey County. They've received two grants from the Department of Water Resources for about $5 million to cover both project phases. Dan and Aaron?
All right, Phil, thank you. There are also future plans to reinforce or replace some sections of the aging levee system and protect the area from future flooding. The county is working with the Corps of Engineers on that project, which could begin in 2016.